Salman Khan has launched a new range of electric bicycles under the Being Human Foundation. These cycles have a starting price tag of Rs 40,000 and go up to Rs 57,000 for the top model. What's interesting about these cycles is that they can also be ridden with the help of the onboard battery pack, a riding mode which can be initiated with the flick of a switch. This feature can come in handy in scenarios such as when the rider is approaching a steep climb or simply help in reducing the fatigue of the rider. The company claims that the cycle have been tested for a period of about 1.5 years prior to the launch, which coincides with the World Environment Day. Atul Gupta, Managing Director and CEO at Being Human eCycle, will be leading the company and was formerly Executive Vice President, Suzuki Motorcycle India. The cycles are claimed to have a range of 30 kilometers and have a top speed of 25 km/h. It is targeted at cyclists of all age. It has now been confirmed that the upcoming Mahindra Scorpio facelift would have a refined and revised 6-speed automatic transmission from the XUV500. But since the XUV500 ASIN made 6-speed unit was engineered for transverse engine applications, it will have to be re-engineered for the Scorpio's longitudinal layout. The biggest talking point for the SUV, though, will be the engine update. The 2.2-liter M-Hawk unit is expected to develop 140 HP in the facelifted SUV. The torque figure is likely to be revised as well. The Scorpio SUV has been a popular offering from Mahindra alongside the more premium XUV500, which is also expected to receive a facelift, its second since launch, shortly. Expanding its superbike range in the country, Piaggio India has launched the Aprilia Shiva 900 and Dorsodaro 900 motorcycles at an introductory price of Rs 11.99 lakhs and Rs 12.5 lakhs respectively. The introductory prices, however, are only available till 30th June and will be revised to Rs 13.32 lakhs for the Shiva 900 and Rs 13.83 lakhs for the Dorsodaro 900. The superbikes will be available through the bike maker's Motoplex dealerships located in Pune, Chennai, Kochi, Bangalore and Hyderabad. Both motorcycles were first unveiled at the 2016 EICMA Motorcycle Show and are imported in the country as completely built units. The Aprilia Shiva 900 is a naked roadster and replaces the Shiva 750 globally, while the Aprilia Dorsodaro 900 is a replacement to the Dorsodaro 750 and is a dual-purpose motorcycle. This also marks the launch of the Aprilia Shiva brand in India. The Aprilia Shiva 900 gets a 4.3-inch TFT instrument console that displays all the vital information. The system also allows smartphone connectivity through the EMP kit, providing access to the calls and audio files. In terms of electronic assist, the bike comes equipped with advanced traction control and an upgraded version of ride-by-wire with electronic accelerator system. While the Shiva is an all-new brand for India, Aprilia already sells the Dorsodaro 1200 in the country and the 900 is the more affordable version of the dual-purpose motorcycle. The Dorsodaro 900 shares the same hardware as the Shiva 900, including multiple riding modes. Sales figures of the Mahindra KUV100 suggest that the car is not doing as well as it was supposed to be, and that's exactly why the company has decided to give the car a much-needed facelift. The development is quite surprising as the Mahindra KUV100 went on sale in January 2016. The SUV-style hatchback's proportions and styling are a letdown for prospective buyers, and Mahindra is working on a facelift that will bring a cleaner design and a redone tailgate, reports Autocar India. Interior changes, if planned, are not known at the moment. The update should hopefully give a boost to the sales. In April, only 2,141 units of the car were sold, which marks over 50% drop in YOY sales. Along with the new Mahindra KUV100, Mahindra is working on a facelift for the Mahindra Scorpio and Mahindra XUV500 to gain its grip back in the utility vehicle segment, it was reported. The facelifted Mahindra Scorpio was bike testing for the first time earlier this week, hiding a refreshed front and rear. The 2017 Nissan Micra with new features has been launched in India with prices starting at Rs 5.99 lakhs. Not to be confused with the new generation Micra that is now on sale internationally, Nissan India continues to sell the current generation model in the country, and the update is the automaker's tryst to keep the model relevant amidst a host of offerings in the segment. More so, the fifth generation Micra won't be hitting the Indian markets anytime soon. The MY 2017 Nissan Micra gets automatic headlamps with follow me function along with rain sensing wipers and spotty orange accents added to the cabin. There are no changes to the styling on the hatchback, which remains the same since the facelifted version arrived in 2013. Engine options on the Nissan Micra get no changes either, with power coming from the 1.2-liter petrol motor churning 73 bhp and 104 nm of peak torque, while there is also the 1.5-liter diesel that belts out 63 bhp and 160 nm of peak torque. Both power mills are paired to a 5-speed manual transmission, while the petrol continues to get the CVT Xtronic automatic transmission. The facelifted Skoda Octavia is due for an India launch around July 10. The updated sedan will feature cosmetic updates both inside and out, which will see it adopting a quad headlamp setup similar to that seen on the old Mercedes E-Class. It will get all LED lights, a new infotainment system with an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system with WLAN connectivity for smartphone integration, two umbrellas tucked into the doors, a driver fatigue detection system, ambient lighting with adjustable colors, a rear view camera, and hands-free parking system. The mid-level variants will get additional airbags with the count set. The top trim is expected to carry on offering 8 airbags. The Octavia will also get larger 17-inch alloy wheels as opposed to the current 16 inches. Under the hood, the car will continue to be offered with the range of 1.4 and 1.8-liter petrol and 2.0-liter diesel engines from the outgoing model, paired with a choice of manual or DSG automatic gearboxes. It's official. Triumph Motorcycles India has sent out invites for the launch of its new 2017 Street Triple motorcycle. Bookings of the upcoming middleweight bike have already commenced. The Street Triple R and the Street Triple RS are likely to follow later in the year. The updated Street Triple series features a revised engine with new camshafts, Newcastle-plated aluminium barrels, and the crankshaft. The British automaker claims that only 10% of the engine components have been carried over from the previous generation model. The new 765cc engine, which is claimed to shed about 1.5 kg over the outgoing version, is available in three states of tune: 111 bhp with 71 nm of torque, 116 bhp with 75 nm of torque, and 121 bhp with 75 nm of torque for the Street Triple S, Street Triple R, and Street Triple RS trims respectively. This engine comes mated to a 6-speed transmission that sends power to the rear wheel. The motorcycle continues to use the same chassis as the outgoing Street Triple, but now features a revised swing arm and new mounting points. The entry-level S-variant features Showa suspension, a ride-by-wire throttle, two riding modes, ABS, and switchable traction control. Kia has unveiled the design sketches for its new upcoming subcompact SUV, the Stonic. The new Stonic is essentially Kia's version of the new Hyundai Kona and will eventually make it to India once Kia officially launches its cars in India. The new Stonic has a more crossover-like design language as compared to the larger SUVs from Kia that features a more upright and more conventional SUV stance and design. In terms of design language, as we mentioned earlier, the Stonic takes a more crossover-ish approach just like the Kona. However, as compared to the Kona, the design is a lot more subdued and will probably be preferred to the common Joe too. The front design is sharp and sporty, and the Kia family grille seems to be finished in a shade of satin grey along with a similarly painted front lip. The headlights do remind a little of some of the larger SUVs in the Kia range and bonnet, and has a similar clamshell-like design. The interior is quite simple and is finished in a shade of black with a grey dashboard. The interior also gets orange accent pieces on the central tunnel and central console, but we guess those will be customizable. The clean interior design also has a large centrally mounted screen, which will most likely be a touchscreen with inbuilt navigation, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. At Tesla's annual shareholder meeting this week, CEO Elon Musk discussed plans for new products including the Model Y. Shown in this recently released teaser image, the Model Y is expected to hit roads around 2019. With production at the Fremont factory bursting at the seams, Musk said Model Y will require a new plant with a location that has yet to be determined. Manufacturing improvements can be achieved to build the vehicle in an entirely new way, and capital expenditures can be decreased by a factor of 2 from the Model 3. He also noted demand for the Model Y will probably exceed demand for the Model 3. Following the Model Y, Tesla will produce an electric cargo van, pickup and minibus, all using the chassis of the Model X. Tesla's shift from producing only cars to also launching commercial vehicles will come as a part of its master plan, Path Dukes, a strategy that also outlines ambitions to take the lead with autonomous technology and transform the public transport sector. The Jeep Compass is one of the most anticipated SUV launches this year. The Made in India SUV will be the most affordable product from the iconic American company when it is launched in India, which, according to our sources, should happen in the first week of August. The first units of the Jeep Compass are already rolling out from Fiat Chrysler Automobiles plant in Ranjangaon, Maharashtra, with demo units set to reach dealerships by the end of June. The right-hand drive variants of the Jeep Compass will only be produced in India and exported to other right-hand drive markets internationally. Expected to be priced in Rs 20 to 25 lakh range, the Jeep Compass will go up against the likes of the Hyundai Tucson, Volkswagen Tiguan and the upcoming next-gen Honda CR-V. Jeep complains to have achieved close to 70% parts localization for the Compass, which could mean that it will be a value for money product. For the money, you get an SUV which is compact, smart looking inside out and feature packed while placing a high priority on safety. Moreover, the Compass stays true to Jeep's all-road, all-weather capabilities. The Jeep Compass in India will be offered with two powertrains, a 2.0-litre turbocharged diesel developing 170 PS and 1.4-litre turbocharged petrol developing 162 PS. Transmission options include a 6-speed manual or a 7-speed dual-clutch transmission, while 4-wheel drive and Jeep's Select Terrain Management System will also be available. It is unclear as to how many variants the Jeep Compass will be offered in, but we hope the Trailhawk variant makes it here.